Yo, man, welcome back to another video, man. It's YoungChris2k, man. Before we start this video, man, I need y'all to hit that subscribe button. When you hit that subscribe button, hit that post notification button, you know, turn on that bell so you know every time I drop a video, you'll be the first one to see. See how smooth I did that? Yeah. Anyway, y'all, today, man, we got Yungeen Ace through the pain, all right? Now, he goes, I think this is like, you know, he just tells his whole story about, you know, how his brother's name get killed and all that, you know what I'm saying? I think that's how it goes. I ain't seen it yet. It's 34 minutes long and 40, it's 34 minutes and 40 seconds long, so y'all know it's probably gonna be two or three parts to this because that's too damn long for me. And yeah, man, I mean, this is gonna be great, you know what I'm saying? I ain't did this before, a Yungeen Ace one, so yeah, let's do this shit, bro.
So I'm on some shit. I'm like, alright.
Jacksonville police have arrested the victim of the quadruple shooting.
All you heard was
the local rapper who survived a shooting near the St. John's Town Center earlier this week.
You know, when they take my hand, I drop my phone.
And behind bars.
I just blink out.
And he had no gun on him that night.
I'm like, brother, I got you. Just open the door.
Shit, live for the day. Shit, we might die tomorrow.
Life on the line, I'll die for you, you're gonna die for me.
You've been dealing for so much, it's like you get used to that shit.
You gotta be a, you gotta be more than a soldier to make it through Jacksonville.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Let me go ahead. What the? Yeah, you can get copyrighted just because of that shit. You know what I'm saying?
It cut right here. You either walk through this cut to another neighborhood back there. Shit. We run through the cut, running from the police, jumping out of the car, run through the neighborhood. Just look cut, but the police done closed it up.
Oh, he was a good child. He used to run around with his diaper on. He had long hair. Only place he liked to really stay is under me. Me and Trayvon.
She my best friend. I know if nobody got me, she got me. Wrong or right, she gonna ride in the car with me till them wheels fall off. You know what I'm saying? We ain't never had nothing. I got seven.
And you know what's crazy, bro? And all parents is like this. A lot of parents is like this. And I understand, but still. Your son is not a good son if he out there taking other lives, okay? That's not a good person. That's never a good person. And stop fucking lying to yourself because that's never a good person. I hate when people say this. It'd be gang mamas. Like, I swear to God, it'd be these gang members' mama that be saying, "Hey, well, he was always a good kid. He was. He was out there toting pistols at 15. He was out there in the streets at 15. He's a good kid. He's a good kid, yeah. He's definitely a good kid. He out there toting pistols at 15, taking lives at 15. Probably was toting that shit at 12, taking lives at 14. You know what I'm saying? So, you can miss me with that good kid shit, because that ain't even true. Like, no, I don't believe none of that. Well, I got a good kid. Like, I understand your mama's always going to be there for you. She's going to be that person I protected that beside, but, bro, she can't protect you if you go to jail, you know what I'm saying? She can't do none of that. All she gonna do is cry, act like she did not know that it was gonna happen. Like, that is like that. I hate mamas like that. I really do, bro. It's like, bro, you know he out here taking lives, all right? Don't go and cry if you know what I'm saying? I understand if you cry if your kid gets killed and all that, but you know he was in the streets doing it. You know what I'm saying? You know he was in the streets doing this. You know what comes with the streets. Everybody knows. And I hate when people act blind to it. Like, you know what happens when you jump into the streets. You know that if you get into this situation, this might happen. All right? You know if you get into this situation, this might happen. You might lose all your lives. All right? But don't act like, don't do that. Don't act like no good kid. All right? If he was a good kid, the whole car one got shut up for a reason. You know what I'm saying? If he was a good kid, everybody would still be here. All right? Don't be saying that.
Yeah, my brother, on my mama's side. And like, we grew up with no daddy. My daddy was doing 15 years in prison. My other brother's daddy, their daddy was in prison too. Plenty nights when he sleep, you know what I'm saying? My little brothers, they had them. Like, they ain't really know as much until like they got like to a certain age. They knew, but they ain't know for real.
We in Melissa right now, little apartments and shit. You know what I'm saying?
West side zone full shit. Duval County, you know what I'm saying?
This the north side, this where I record at, 32209. A lot of people don't ain't make around here. When I say it out of the way, say it in my lane.
5020 Cleveland apartment right down the street from here. Me and his big brothers, all of we played football together. My brother bought him around, bike round, you know. We built a relationship like that. But you know, Ace, he called me big brother. You know, I feed him knowledge, let him know what's real. You know, that's my little homie though.
I met Ace like, what, my ninth grade year?
And then we had to move here, and then we had to move there. House got shot up, so we had to move from out of there. Went to Clay County. I wish we didn't went to Clay County, because I don't like them.
We in the trenches for real.
Hey, you know what's crazy? He was a good kid, though. You know what I'm saying? Mama already said he was a good kid. That house got shot up. You know what I'm saying? Good kids, you know, every time you're a good kid, your house do get shot up. I don't know where they do that at, but, you know. If you're a good kid, your house gets shot up. That's tight. That is crazy as fuck, bro. Never knew that, though. Never knew if you was a good kid, your house gets shot up. Then you had to move out of the house because it was getting shot up because your son was in the streets. But he's a good kid. He's a good kid. He stayed out of trouble.
Man, why you ain't take me back, bitch? You ain't take me back.
They go my granddaddy and they go AJ you know, right there.
This is for real.
Interview. And my auntie, we on the corner store right here.
They got untucked that bitch now.
My auntie, you tripping.
Oh, man.
Y'all
ain't
have permission to come in the store
with
all that.
We can film in the store?
No. You gotta ask the store owner.
Nah, we good.
I've been knowing about this store since I was young before. You can't get shit free out this store. My auntie on this bitch.
Hey, well, this is a public store. I don't think you can tell nobody they can't go in there and film if it's open for the public. You know what I'm saying? What y'all hiding in there? You know what I mean? If they can't go in there, like, what y'all hiding in there? It's a store, dog. It's a store. You telling me you can't go in there and film in the store? You telling me I can't bring a camera into any store? Like, that's... Come on, bro. It's a public store for a reason, bro. You can bring anything in there. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how Florida works. But I know, like, I'm pretty sure if it's a public place that you can bring anything in there instead of a gun if they have it on there. But if it doesn't have no signs saying no cameras allowed, no nothing, bro, you can bring anything. You got to have signs. You can't just tell nobody you can't bring no damn camera inside the store. I don't see no fucking red sign, no red, you know what I'm saying, how they have the camera right here, and then they put that little red circle around there with the X on it, no camera. I ain't see that. You got to see that. You gotta have some type of, you gotta have something saying that you can't bring nothing in there. Shit, if you can do that for a gun, you can do it for a camera. You know what I mean? But he says his auntie owned the store. I mean, that's what's up. So I mean, she probably got everything for free, really. You know what I'm saying? If your auntie owned that shit, you probably getting like snacks, chips, drinks. You know what I'm saying? For free. You just go in there, you hungry. She just like, hey, go ahead and get you some. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for real.
Oh yeah, real quick. That's one ghetto store too. That's a type of hood store. That's not no regular store to me, bro. I look at that store, I'm like, man, that's crazy, bro. Look like the chink store down the street. You know what I'm saying? Look just like the chink store down the street.
Can't trust nobody. It's Jacksonville. You can't trust your own blood. Shit.
Right now, anything can go down around this motherfucker. You know what
shit,
I'm saying?
Shit, like, for the day, shit. We might die tomorrow.
You gotta be on point out here.
In the bed, church, whatever. Nigga ain't never like.
We got smoke with the whole city, so shit. You never know when, you know what I'm saying? Most definitely, you ain't gonna catch us down bad.
You know what I'm saying? There's killers everywhere, all around the city. But they love me because I don't play the middleman.
I'm a little man.
See, there we go. It's out there, Jacksonville.
Take the fuck off your body while you can.
Shabbat Shab. He on fire and he 904. He like to play poker and he on fire. His whole arm, my son. Dice.
You got even grandma out here repping that Florida stuff. You know what I'm saying? She got the, she, you see that she got the little Dirk dreads. You know what I'm saying? She ain't like little Dirk got too much influence on her. You know what I mean? She driving with tattoos everywhere. You know, she about what she about. You know what I'm saying? She about what, like, you know what I mean? That street life. It seems like she is. You know what I'm saying? She got shit tatted on her. She showing you what she got. You know, she letting y'all know. You know? Especially, like, I don't really talk to nobody that got little Dirk dreads like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you trying to tell me you're an artificial killer or something? Like, what are you trying to do? You trying to, you see that she want to smoke with old girl. You know what I'm saying? She want to smoke with her. She going to ride for little Dirk. She little Dirk twin.
Yeah,
I'm
gonna make you laugh, I'm make you cry.
Shit, get that call, your dog gone, your people gone, shit. But you've been dealing for so much, it's like you get used to that shit.
That's like, good. Oh, so-and-so just got shot. And like, oh, for real? That shit normal, man.
Who you telling?
Let's be real, y'all. If your cousin got shot, you gonna act like, oh, for real? Nah, dog. You gonna be like, my cousin? Like, bro, I hate, bro, this is saying, bro, like, just because it's normal, bro, it ain't gonna be, it's different when your family members get hit up. I don't care what nobody, somebody close to you, you ain't gonna say, oh, for real? You gonna be like, you know what I'm saying, devastated, because you ain't, you gonna be like, I can't believe that he just got killed. Because it's always like that, bro. It's always like that.
First song I made, I was 14 years old. I was at Melbourne Park on the bench. The park got a basketball court, little pond and shit. First song was called Stop Stalking Me. I was already going through shit, you feel what I'm saying? Damn. But like, me going through shit, that's how I vent to people. Like, I only want to talk. When you put them headphones in or put them on the speaker, you gonna feel like you there with me. Like, damn.
I just heard them in the room singing a song, You Don't Wanna Go to War with Me. And they asked me, like, could we do a video here? And I told them no.
Go to War, that was my first video I ever shot.
First video I seen on with that Go to War. I knew he was gonna be something, even when I first met him.
See, we always joking about how we gonna make it and all this shit. That's back then, you feel what I'm saying? And Trey's black, we gotta turn up on that bitch, you hear me? So, next thing you know, we'll go through beats, boom, boom. And then just that beat just hit me, boom. I'm like, fuck a nigga, don't wanna go to war with us. Like, a nigga don't wanna go to war with me, I'm gonna die about me, you hear me? So I'm on that, don't wanna go to war.
Yeah. I definitely had to stop it right there. I'm gonna have to definitely mute that hoe. But yeah, that song, You Don't Wanna Go to War with Me, like, bro, I should have reacted to that song. God, I don't listen every day, but every now and then I just put it on SoundCloud. I'll be like, yeah, you don't wanna go. Like, it goes so, it does go hard. You know what I'm saying? You don't wanna go to war with me. Yo. You don't wanna. Yeah, like that shit goes so hard, bro. They said that was his first video he ever made. Like, bro, that's a hit, man. Like, that was definitely a hit, dog. Like, if he got that through his pain, his suffering, and all that, yeah, bro. I didn't really start listening to Yungeen Ace. I went to my homie house, and I remember it was Ian, you know what I'm saying? Went to go fix some stuff up, and he was playing, My Pain? It was Pain, you know what I'm saying, by Yungeen Ace. And I was sitting there, I matched him a blunt, and I was like, damn, what this fuck? Pain? I never heard this song. I'm like, going through all this pain, talking about pain. I'm like, ooh, this nigga, oh, who this? And when he said Yungeen Ace, I was like, Yungeen Ace, who that? So I immediately went, I left that house. I went in the car to play the song again. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had to go play that song over. I was playing that song the whole way I got home. So, you know, I was playing that song 3 or 4 times. You know what I'm saying? Because I even downloaded from Apple. I was like, yeah, I got to go download this. This is a banger. You know what I'm saying? It was that good of me. Then I started really following Yungeen Ace. I started, like, getting all his songs. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, see, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is all copyright claims right here. And I'm just going to do that. I'm going to have to, like, let that go.
Yo, in my house, and I told you I don't do it. just getting police just coming through my doors, coming. They thought we had guns, but it wasn't no guns.
Hell yeah, that's why I went to jail. Police came kicking through shit, SWAT team shit, tank trucks, all that type of shit, kicked that bitch in. Thinking they finna go find all this crazy ass shit that they mix up together and think they finna come find, feel what I'm saying? But it was nothing like that. I'm always three steps ahead of people, feel what I'm saying? I'm always three steps ahead.
Don't wanna go to war with me. See, that's that shit, bro. That song right there. I can't smoke no weed. Gotta smoke away the pack. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I can't smoke no weed, so you know what I'm saying? I don't know how it went. Yeah, I can't smoke no weed, so I can't smoke away the pain. Some shit like that. I got that song, too. Like, I tell y'all, bro, when I started listening to Yungeen Ace, bro, I started going hard. I started downloading this man's stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. But, like I said, I can't get these copyright claims, bro. These are popping up. Unexpectedly, you know what I'm saying? Then he got a song with when he came back. I know he have a song with NBA YoungBoy. I swear he have a song with NBA YoungBoy.
Oh, little kids and shit. I remember when I was younger. A nigga couldn't tell me nothing. You're missing some shit. I already know how these niggas feel, shit. These little niggas, shit. They really ain't got no choice.
But they gonna listen to you, cause
They gonna listen. But this is the thing, though. Like, sometimes you ain't got no choice. They ain't like they chose life.
Arrived.
Hey, what we pulling up at? Yeah, I be lying my ass off.
See what I mean?
Yes.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right.
No!
Hey.
Speed on my brother!
Step down, believe that. Man, I just came out a bit to come see all y'all, boy. I'm chilling. I'm on this thing right here, though. I'm on this community control shit, you feel me? So it's like I can't really do much. I can't go to the store if I want to. All my shit, I got to plan my schedule out bi-weekly. We come from the trenches, you feel me?
Yeah.
So a lot of them, they won't understand where we come from. You feel what I'm saying? We ain't choose this life. That shit is high. That shit play out, you feel me? You don't want to be in this bit all your life. There's a lot of niggas in that bit facing life. 45 years, you know what I'm saying? One was doing 35. Off of something he ain't had to. You feel what I'm saying?
That's tough, bro. Fuck, that is tough. His homie doing 35, something he ain't do. But that's how the street goes. Sometimes you gotta take the rap for your homeboys, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do, bro. Sometimes you gotta take the rap. Sometimes you gonna have to, I mean, that's how it goes, though, you know? I feel bad for you, dude. And I'm glad he went to go talk to him. Like, bro, that's some good shit, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? Giving back, bro. You going there and talking to the, you know, giving other people hope. You going to the little county jails or whatever. I don't know what this is, but, you know, you going in there and talking to them juvenile kids, you know what I'm saying? Telling them, like, you know, we came from the same cloth, you know what I'm saying? We all built different, but, bro, it's Jacksonville, you know what I'm saying? Nobody know the pain. Nobody know the struggles we go through. And it's so sad because everybody going through it. Okay, every state going through the same thing, the same exact thing. I'm telling you, just the struggles of life might be a little bit different, but it's the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Just everybody need, like, well, it's always, it's like it's always the poor community, which is the same community I'm from. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like you said, bro. It's like you didn't choose this life. You know what I mean? And this life, shit, life chose you. You know what I'm saying? So you, like, either, like, bro, this is how it goes, bro. I swear to God, either you know what I'm saying, you gonna go to school, do it the right way, or you gonna follow to the victim of the streets, bro. And it's not like you want to go to the streets. Sometimes people don't got no other way to do it. You know what I'm saying? Some people don't have that luxury to just go to school and do it the right way. Like, no one, a lot of people don't have that type of luxury. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people have to jump into the streets because their family members are, you know, their mama can't do it by themselves, so she can't pay the bills. Some days, like you said, some days they couldn't go to sleep. So, like, you know, I mean, some days they couldn't eat. So, you know, like, and that goes just for, like, a lot of family members. Like, for everybody. Like, that's literally, like, that's every state, you know what I'm saying, that have the same situation. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, fam. Like, it's sad, but I understand that if you gotta hop in the street to make that bread to help your mom out, you gotta do what you gotta do. And you know the consequences. But your mama, the only thing I kind of take from this video that I didn't like was, you know what I'm saying, his mom said it was a good kid. I mean, like, how, bro? Like, I guess you can be a good kid in the streets running and taking other lives. Like, I just don't believe no kid is good if they're taking lives. You out there taking lives, fam, you're not no good kid, bro. You're not, bro. You out there, you know, like, taking another life. I can't say that you're a good kid, bro. I'll just say, yeah, he cool, you know what I'm saying? He's straight. But good kid? Nah, bro. If you can sit there and take a life, that's different. That's like a whole nother meaning. You know what I'm saying? That's like a whole nother level, actually. Like, you know what I'm saying? Of, you know, you taking lives and stuff. Because, bro, it's hard. Like, to me, I think it's hard to take a life, bro. Because that's somebody, you know what I'm saying? That's somebody's son or somebody's daughter or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And you're not taking their life. You're taking them away from their people. You know what I'm saying? So, like, none of that shit. Nobody thinks about that when they are in that situation. But if you could just think about that just a little bit, just a little second. Because if y'all both think about that, then y'all both would just go a different way about it. But I know that's in a fantasy world, so that's not going to really happen, you know?
Man, all that time, that's when everybody leave. You know what I'm saying? Everybody love you. When that bitch doing that gangster shit, everybody want to jump in that stolo with you. You feel what I'm saying? But when the police come get you, all them niggas up. You feel what I'm saying? All that. All right, yo. After the incident, when my brother them got shot, well, I got shot too. I got shot 8 times.
Damn.
The night before.
That nigga. He was on some 50 Cent. 50 Cent just got shot one more time. Just one extra bolt bullet. 50 got shot 9. You got shot 8. Woo. 8 times. You know how lucky he is, bro? A lot of people don't even survive one time. One bullet. You telling me this dude survived 8 times? Oh, Jesus on his side. Jesus was literally on this man's side.
23. Birthday was coming up. Everybody that I be with, they got number they go by. Every time I think of C4, I think 4. Every time I think 23, I think 23. You know what I'm saying? Kwan is 2. I go run in the room, I go jump on him and shit. I'm like, 23, nigga, happy birthday, nigga. I say, what's up, LeBron? He said, shit. I ain't supposed to make it to this day.
See that dude?
What? My tattoo?
See that dude. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'm all the brothers, though. Mm-hmm. They all the way
down. That shit crazy how that shit happened.
Oh, yeah. Y'all seen that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's all the way. But look, though, in these streets, that would come with it. Y'all know that. That would come with it. That's why y'all gotta watch everything y'all do. Watch every move, feel what I'm saying?
They say it's a reason, so they say God do everything for a reason, feel what I'm saying? He put his toughest soldiers through the toughest battles. I mean, I live for the day I might die tomorrow.
We gotta go out to eat. I'm on my phone and shit, I'm trying to find out where the fuck my girlfriend at, cause she was eating too. So I'm trying to find out where the fuck she at. I'm about to go with her, cause 23. And Quan, they trying to go with some hoes, you feel what I'm saying? So I'm on some shit. I'm like, alright, let's see, we stop at a red light. But he heard was that pop pop pop. And when that bitch hit my hand, I dropped my phone. I heard 23, he was on the side of me. I hollered at him, he's screaming and shit. So I'ma die for you. You gonna die for me. Life on the line. I jump over the shield. I'm like, LeBron, I got you.
Damn, they died at this. Two people died at the scene. God, that's tough, bro. I just only read a little bit. I didn't just skip. God, that is tough, bro. That is tough. at the scene. So this person must have died at the hospital.
Just open the door. Open the door. When shit serious, he called by my real name. He like, Kente, I can't move. Kente, I can't move. Kente, I can't move. Like, just hearing that, I can't move. That shit just fucked my mind up. Like, that shit played through my shit all day. Kente, I can't move. Kente, I can't move. You know what I'm saying? Ace, call ambulance. By the time I look back around, there's already people surrounded. So I said, what shit happened? Call my girlfriend and shit. After that, we go to the ambulance come, but one car. Keep in mind, I ain't even look at my little brother. Still to the day, I ain't look at my little brother. He laying down on four lap. They came, they grabbed 23 first. They left. Another one came, they came and got me. Me and 23 outside the car. I'm laying down. Wow. Me and 23 on the ground and shit. This is before they came and got him. I'm laying down, but I'm calling out for him. I'm reaching for him. I'm like 23. But he not answering back to me. I'm like 23. I'm reaching out to him though. RJ, Royale, I'm calling about everything. You feel me? He ain't never answer. Damn. So I just close my eyes and say, I'm finna faint. I say, I'm about to die. And I'm like, they killed my brother. And this before I even knew anyone was dead. I said, they killed my brother. I just had a feeling. So we get to the ambulance. All that shit, Cobra's on the next door to me. They brought him back to life four times. He forever four. Everything happened with him four times. They brought him back to life four times. I was in the hospital bed. They told me, the doctor told me I was finna die. I told him to keep 100. You think I'ma live? He said, I don't know, it might be. I said, keep 100. Do you think I'm gonna live? He said, it's too many holes. Like, I don't think you gonna make it, feel what I'm saying?
Then they arrested this man after he got, bro, that shit stupid, bro. They arrested this man after he just got shot up. Like, how you do that? How you arrest somebody after they just got shot up? Just because he violated parole, I understand, but still. Like that, they don't care. They do not care, bro. The system don't care. That's why nobody care about the system, bro. Because the system doesn't even help you out. You know what I mean? I understand you violated parole. And like, if you never would have done this, this wouldn't happen. Well, you wouldn't even know. You wouldn't even know if this could occur anywhere. You know what I'm saying? My thing is, how did they get this man's location? How did they know? You know what I'm saying? That's the situation. Like, how did they know somebody outed somebody? Somebody they know outed them and gave them their location. Or they just spotting them on the highway. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the tough part. That's a tough situation. But anyway, y'all, man, if y'all like this video, man, y'all go ahead and hit the subscribe button. If you don't like the video, still hit the subscribe button. Make sure y'all hit that like button. Make sure you have that share button. Yeah, please share it to your friends and your family members, okay? Thank you. All right, this is YoungChris2k, man. I'm out. Wait to part 2. All right, deuces.